Hello and welcome back to another Future Doghouse production. We're continuing our journey on this manuscript. If you like a copy of this manuscript, please find me on Facebook or Instagram. Send me a message and I'll send you a link. Here we go. Hemolysis. We've got alpha, beta, and gamma. Hemolysis. What is hemolysis? Well, it's basically red blood cells being destroyed. Lysis of red blood cells. All right, and this is useful for streptococci identification. Basically, if you know that a certain bacteria has alpha hemolysis or beta hemolysis or gamma hemolysis, you can figure out that maybe that bacteria could possibly be, if it's alpha hemolysis, S. pneumoniae or S. viridans, for example. All right, alpha hemolysis means it's a partial lysis of red blood cells, RBCs. And it shows up as greenish opaque zones. So here would be the blood agar plate with greenish opaque zones. And you will have S. pneumoniae or S. viridans. That's the possible bacteria that would be alpha hemolytic. And there's no Lancefield classification for S. pneumoniae or S. viridans. Now, Lancefield classifications is a whole nother ballpark, and we'll be discussing that later, okay? Continuing on our journey is beta hemolysis, and beta hemolysis is complete lysis of red blood cells. And there is usually a clear halo zone in or on the blood agar plate. And the bacteria that has beta hemolysis is group A Streptococcus pyogenes, group B Streptococcus agalactiae. Okay, and those are the two bacteria or the groups that can show up as beta hemolytic in the streptococci family, genus. And there's also two other bacteria I like to mention that are also beta hemolytic, which is Listeria monocytogenes and our favorite E. coli. All right, gamma. Gamma hemolysis is no lysis of red blood cells. And this group is group D streptococci. Group D for diarrhea. These streptococcus causes diarrhea. Group D for different. These streptococcus are different, so because they are usually enterococci. Okay, enterococci of the streptococcus genus, and it's S. bovis as well is also a group D or gamma hemolytic bacteria. Lancefield classification, very quickly, since we mentioned it here, I like to explain it over here. Lancefield classification is based off of antigenic characteristics of C carbohydrates of cell wall. Wow, that's a mouthful. Basically, an antigen is presented, and if the C carbohydrate is different, based off of different antigenic characteristics, you can group them A through S. And the only ones that we care about is A, B, and D. Group A streptococcus, group B streptococcus, and group D streptococcus. And these are pathogenic, hence in red. And you know D is, gamma hemolytic is group D. And we know group A and B is beta hemolytic. And we know that alpha hemolytic bacteria, alpha hemolytic streptococcus, have no Lancefield classifications. Simple. Now don't get confused with alpha hemolytic and group A streptococcus, because A for alpha is different. A for alpha is no Lancefield classification bacteria, streptococcus bacteria. And alpha here, the group A here is a beta hemolytic bacteria. Group A is here under beta hemolytic. All right, if you like this video and you want more of these videos, please click subscribe. Thank you and have a nice day.
Congratulations, you are a medical student. One day, you will be a qualified doctor and your home will be a hospital or a clinic. But for now, your journey begins in the lecture hall. You will listen to countless hours of lectures and spend evening after evening in the library reading page after page of medical theory. And guess what? This is the easy part. The hardest part is retaining your medical knowledge so it's there when you need it. For example, examinations. But don't worry, we are here to help. Meet Jeff. Jeff is a good student. He goes to all his lectures. He says no to parties so he can stay late in the library. But when it's time to take the exams, Jeff freezes. The knowledge that he spent so long learning just isn't there anymore. Now meet Jennifer. Like Jeff, she is a good student. But instead of just reading textbooks late into the night, Jennifer uses technology to help her study. She also watches lectures on YouTube and practices her knowledge with Qpee, a medical quiz app and online platform. Jennifer likes Qpee because it has 10,000 practice questions covering her entire medical course. This means she can practice her medical knowledge from anywhere and in a way that actually prepares her for the exams. Because she is practicing with exam-style questions, when she takes real exams, she'll be ready. Don't be a Jeff. Begin your 7-day free trial with Qpee today.